Right.
Sure, it's taking a long time for this elevator to get here.
We're stuck
you mean the elevator shaped like Alnick from Legends of the Hidden Temple?
Yes.
Let's just open his big mouth.
Go for it. I wonder what's inside.
Let's just push the button again. It sure is taking a while.
Hey, the door opened. It is people.
Hi, I'm Homer.
Hi, I'm Carbon Fox.
I'm Archon Gold, aka a Lost Sandwich.
And I'm Dude Man Teeth.
We're gonna show you how to make switches. Switches. The life of Halo 3. Okay, I'll explain it. Come on, let's go over here and show you the min-max switch, the basic switch. The min-max switch is basically where you spawn two of the same objects that are breakable. Basically, you set the second object to not spawn a start. The first object is set to not respawn, but it will spawn a start, as you can see, I just hit it. When you break the first object, it tells the second object, like so. And
yay!
It tells the second object to spawn, because the minimum number of objects allowed in the map is like, how do you explain that?
Insert complicated response here.
Yeah. Basically, for example, there are three of these on the map. The minimum runtime is set to two. So when there's less than two, this one will spawn when there's less than two.
So what you're saying is, this one will spawn when there's less than two.
Yes, but you can use this in many ways. You can use a fusion coil, but unfortunately, Doom MP has deleted the last fusion coil, so we can't spawn any in this map.
Warning.
But what you can do is you can have, like, over here we have an example right here. Our example door that we made. Over here, Chris, come up here. Right here we got a power-up blocking a fusion coil. When you grab the power-up, when you grab the power-up and let it free-fall, it breaks it. Then over here...
Wait,
could you use this min-max and combine it with this so you can make the mouth open and close?
Yeah, that's what it does.
Not after 10 seconds, but another switch that closes.
Oh,
yes,
no.
You can.
I don't. You can.
Yep. Hold on. Yes, you can. You can, but we didn't have enough time to make it in our short time frame. But basically, what happens here is this fusion coil blows up, which then forces another one right here. You can see the little blue thing to spawn. Launching it over here, blowing up that propane tank, blowing up the gravulus, making the dumpsters drop. Okay, come over here, and then someone activate it.
I'll activate it.
Activate it.
Yay.
There we go, spawn, and then it blows up the propane tank. It blows the gravulus. Now the door is open.
Rapist inside of there. Don't go in.
Basically, as you can see, the dumpster is what we call asleep. Don't touch it. We have a wall that's merged with the dumpster. So when someone hits the dumpster, it will then push the dumpster through the wall, pushing this fusion coil into the main cannon, which then launches at these fusion coils, blowing them up, and then using min-max, drops them, which then launches them again.
Yay!
Essentially, you walk onto this pallet on the ground, and it basically spawns a barrel, in this example, in front of you, so we can jump onto a ledge. But it could...
Carol!
But it... Oh, God. Yeah, so it can spawn a gravulus, if you want it to.
Here,
or walk on the pallet, and... it'll spawn a fusion coil at the end for you to jump on and get out of here.
Okay.
Now what this is, basically, it's something that we call, what was it, vibration technology?
Yeah, I thought it was touch technology.
Or something like that, but basically,
Either one sounds sexual.
Where is he? Oh, hi. We have regenerators hidden inside the box right here that are inside this box that are asleep. By throwing a regenerator, it creates a field that touches every object around it, and it wakes the regenerator up, like so. And then pushes it up, and then you can push the dumpster. I need help pushing it, because only two people can push it. Then I need help pushing it. Okay. Behind it is a safe with full of weapons. What's inside the safe? There's like a...
Nope. Bad anal flank.
Alright. This is like this humongous gigantic gun.
Catapult.
Okay, stop, you Mendes.
Alright, there's about, what, 6 man cannons that are geomerged within these 16 geomerged,
as well.
Yeah, those.
And here's how you mass shoot it. An RV switch is a vehicle, whether it be a mongoose, a warthog, and basically you flip it upside down or on its side, and you put, say, a fusion coil right beside it, and you put a wall there. You can't see it, but when you press RB, it flips the vehicle, flipping the fusion coil, which could blow it up, or which spawns another fusion coil.
Depends on where it falls.
There. Right, we're dead.
Hold it.
Use.
What the hell? Counting all different
ideas drifting away. Past and present, that'll matter now. You can just hold it out.
Whoa. Watch your moving and elliptical back. Think it's not what you say. What you say is way too complicated. Falling, I thought I couldn't tell how to fall out. Oh. I'm still the last one.